Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we will talk about culture media, which is commonly used in laboratory for growing bacteria and their preparation method, right? So media, which contains mainly food for the growth of these microbes. It is very important when we have to grow these microbes in the laboratory, right? So there are various modifications, like in ancient times, simple medium, like complex media were used, like skim milk, beef extract. These were used without knowing their exact composition, right? Sugarcane juice were also even used. So all these were like, without knowing their exact composition, these were being used. Later on, like some defined media, having all the exact chemical compositions known, is being used, right? So based on this, so media could be solid, liquid, or semi-solid. Media could be, then its chemical composition could be known or unknown, right? Or it could be synthetic or natural one. And sometimes media for growing, we need, for mass production, we need liquid media. For isolation, we need solid media. If you have to transport, in case of patient, if you have to transport for a long distance, then we need a transport media, right? And then if there are like certain bacteria which is very similar, almost similar, right? So we want to differentiate between them. So in that case, we need selective media or differential media. So media can be categorized on all these types, right? Okay. So what are culture? We all know what is culture. These are techniques used to grow the microbes in the laboratory by providing proper medium, right? So what is culture media? Culture media, these are the food required by microbes, right, to grow in the laboratory, that is culture media, right? Different microbes require different nutrient materials. Culture media may vary in form, composition, depending on the species cultivated. There could be a solid media, liquid media used to grow, transport and store organisms. Complex media, urine, earlier it was urine, chicken, meat, broth, these were used. This was given by Louis Pasteur. Then there was solid media, potato extract and several. Potato extract earlier in nowadays, potato dextrose are used, right? Earlier, potato extract simply it was used to boil and they were used for isolating fungi. Robert Koch, gelatin melts. Earlier, gelatin was also used, but their main problem was that certain bacteria, they produce gelatinase, so they will dissolve this gelatin, right? So now that's why it is not being used. Melts at 24 degrees Celsius, microbes used it as a substrate. Right? Agar for the first time was used for the growth of microbes in by Walter Hessler, right? So we will see all these. Okay. What are the requirements of a culture media? Everyone needs carbon source, nitrogen source, right? Salts, pH should be there, optimum pH will be there. Various growth factors, vitamins, indicators, inhibitors, right? To inhibit the growth of others and promote the growth of specific desired one, right? And energy source and oxidation reduction, right? So based on whatever we talked earlier, culture media can be either liquid based on their physical nature. They could be liquid, they could be semi-solid, or they could be solid, right? Based on their chemical composition, they could be defined where you know all the exact elements of the media. This is a complex media. You don't know, but you have simply used from the nature or some other one, but you don't know the exact. You can't reproduce it exactly, right? Functional types. They are used to support the growth of our bacteria, right? Supporting media. Enrich. You want to enrich the particular bacteria, that is enriched media. Selective. You want to, among 3 to 4, 5, you one, while you want to reject the another one, that is selective media. Differential media. You want to differentiate, right? Yes, this particular strain microbacteria is this one only. In their case, we need differential media. These are based on functional types, right? So media based on physical, there could be liquid media generally used for growing mass production. Solid media, it is generally used for isolation, right? Liquid media and solidified media, liquid and solidified media are routinely used in microbiological labs. Solidified media particularly is important. Both defined and complex media can be solidified with the addition of generally agar. Agar is a solidifying agent, right? Most commonly 1.5% is used agar. Agar, these are extracted from algae, right? D-galactose-3,6 anhydro L-galactose and D-galacturonic acid. These are extracted from the red algae. Right. The melting temperature is about 90 degrees Celsius for agar, and solidifying temperature is near about 40 to 45. They get start solidifying, right? Microbes grow on agar medium can be incubated at a wide range of temperatures. Agar is excellent hardening agent, and because most microorganisms cannot degrade it, that was the major problem with gelatin based media, because they used to produce gelatinase, so they used to degrade it. Other solidifying agents like silica gel is also used to grow autotrophic bacteria, right? But now it is not that much widely used. So media based on chemical composition, that was media based on physical nature, based on chemical composition. One is defined or synthetic medium, when you have, you know, how much carbon is there, how much nitrogen source is there, how much vitamin is there, all the elements are well defined, right? A defined or synthetic medium, so it is basically prepared by human beings, right? So in the laboratory or industry. So a defined or synthetic medium is a type of growth medium where all the chemical components are known and precisely measured. These are sometimes also called chemically defined media. All chemical components are known in a defined medium, right? They consist of a dilute, reproducible solutions of chemically pure, known inorganic and organic compounds. Artificial media of exactly known reproducible composition are called synthetic or chemically defined media, right? This is the same thing. Formulation use of these means require an exact knowledge of the nutritional requirements of the microbes to be cultivated. So that means you need to have all the exact elements which is present, you have to know, right? In order so that you can grow the same organism in the same media repeatedly. Then there is, these can be in liquid form. These complex media could be either in liquid form or in solidified. Liquid form, you don't need to add agar. In solidified media, you need to add agar, right? All defined media are simple but may be constructed from dozens of components. They are widely used in research, as it is often desirable to know what experimental microorganism is metabolizing. For culturing photolithotrophs, photolithotropic autotrophs, cyanobacteria, and photosynthetic protist, chemoorganotrophic heterotrophs, right? One is thiobacillus thioxidans, right? They reduce sulfur and iron, right? Thio, sulfur, bacillus, Rothschild, thioxidans, they oxidize sulfur, right? So this is the particular defined media for this, right? These all are inorganic elements, right? Media based on chemical composition. So one, they are also chemical composition, that is natural or empirical or complex media, right? They are like peptone, beef extract, urine, sugarcane juice, skim milk, all these were like natural, that where microbes can grow, but we don't know the exact composition which what is present where and which component is responsible for growth of these microbes. A natural or empirical complex medium is a type of growth medium used in microbiology that contains a variety of nutrients and ingredients in which the exact chemical composition is not precisely known. These media are often made from natural products and can support the growth of wide variety of microorganisms, right? They are widely used in early days, ancient times, right? Okay, when there was no well-defined media. Milk, skim milk was used. Urine, diluted blood, okay, from animals. Either only in major ingredient, peptone. Peptone, generally, it is a resource of phosphorus, carbon, nitrogen. So it can support the growth of wide number of bacteria. Culture fluids made from beef infusions are commonly called infusion broth, whereas those made from beef extract as extract broth, right? Complex media, this is one example. Tryptic soy broth, right? Exact composition for preparing, what do you call this one? Complex media, right? Media that contains some, it is the same thing. Media that contains some ingredients of unknown chemical composition, right? One is example, nutrient broth, complex media, tryptic broth, and McConkey agar, right? Another one is functional types. How we can get, third condition was functional types. How we can categorize media based on their functions. One is general purpose media for supporting the growth of microbes, for extracting from the sources, right? General purpose media or supportive media, they sustain the growth of many microorganisms. That means most of the microbes can be grown over there, right? Our main purpose is to grow them only, right? Tryptic soy broth and tryptic soy agar. Enriched media, blood and other special nutrients may be added. Purpose media to encourage the growth of first 8 years. Microbes, right, which don't easily grow in normal conditions. These specially fortified media like blood agar. Then there is selective media. Selective media is specialized types of growth media designed to favor the growth of particular microorganisms while inhibiting, they are promoting one and is suppressing the growth of other. This is achieved by either adding certain salts, antibiotics to it, right? That either promote, suppress the growth of certain microbes. How they are achieved? By things like dyes will be added, like some of the dyes, they are inhibited to gram positive, but they promote the gram negative. If salts, gram positive, they have a cell wall. Salt will affect on the cell wall, right? So if salt is being added or dye is added using gram positive will suppress, gram negative will increase, they will be promoted, right? Selective media are widely used in microbiology for isolating, identifying specific types of bacteria from mixed cultures. What are these media? Eosin, methylene blue, they are commonly used for E. coli, yeast extract, malt extract has a low pH determined bacterial growth. McConkie agar, commonly used, supports the growth of gram negative. Then there is mannitol salt agar, they are also being used for gram positive bacteria and differentiate from mannitol, right? If you will see, these are selective media. This is EMB, eosin, methylene blue. This supports what you call. Yes, here E. coli. It is mainly used for E. coli. E. coli, right? E. coli is a gram negative. They don't have a cell wall. It has eosin, methylene. It has eosin dye, right? So kill the all eosin dye is inhibitory to gram positive, but they promote the growth of what you call gram negative. Since gram negative E. coli, they don't have a thick peptidoglycan, so they won't affect that. They will allow gram negative growth of gram negative bacteria. But in case of E. coli, if E. coli are grown over there, they will produce green metallic sheen, right? Green metallic sheen. So this is confirmatory, like yes, this particular bacteria is E. coli because they're producing green metallic sheen, right? If you will grow another bacteria over here, you won't find green metallic sheen. Enterobacter aerogenes, right? Right. Okay. That means they are selecting, right? Similarly, there is eosin in different organisms. Proteus is grown, Salmonella typhi is grown, Staphylococcus aureus is grown. But there, it is mainly for this one, right? This one is gram positive. These two are gram negative. Functional types of differential media. Differential or indicator. They are indicates, right? Or differentiates one organism to another organism. A specialized type of growth media that distinguishes among different groups of microbes and even permit tentative identification of microorganisms based on their biological nature, colony characteristics, right? Okay, any pigmentation is there. Here indicators are used such as neutral red, phenol red, eosin Y or methylene blue. They produce certain pigments or components which will react with the dye and they will produce different color. It is indicative, yes, this particular strain in microbe is there. Visibly indicate the defining characteristics of microorganisms. Example, blood agar, hemolytic and non-hemolytic bacteria, EMB, McConkie, right? If you will see this one, mannitol salt agar, it is commonly used for staph aureus. Mannitol salt agar, if you will grow staph aureus in this, they will produce yellow color, while they won't be able to differentiate among others, right? On the same media, right? Selective because of salt, only staph can grow. They have a particular salt. Mannitol salt is there. So they will support the growth of staph aureus. Generally, they are yellow in colonies. So they will support the growth while they won't support the growth of others. So mannitol salt agar, especially for staph aureus, right? Staph aureus turns yellow, but staphylococcus epidermidis does not. So these are closely related to this one, right? So we can differentiate. Yes, this is staph aureus only, not staph epidermidis, right? There is again staph aureus, many types of with staph aureus, they produce yellow colonies, other one they produce red. Blood agar, if you will see, they produce hemolysis, right? Complete hemolysis, partial hemolysis, no hemolysis, right? So beta hemolysis, streptococcus pyogenes, we can, yes, if they are producing hemolysis, right? Beta partial hemolysis, we can, okay, this one is streptococcus pyogenes. Alpha hemolytic, Escherichia coli. Gamma hemolysis, no hemolysis at all, that is gamma. Staphylococcus epididymitis. This is how we can differentiate based on media. Okay, McConkie agar, It is also again selective and differential media, McConkey, Escherichia coli. They will grow like this. Enterobacter, they will grow like this, right? Proteus vulgaris, they will produce yellow color, salmonataphy. So that means the same media, different organism growing different, right? So that is, it is selective as well as differential media. Why? Because gram positives are inhibited. What will happen? If you will say this is gram negative, this is also gram negative, this is also gram negative, this is also gram negative, this one is gram positive, right? See, here no growth. They are promoting the growth of gram negative, but they are not promoting, they are inhibiting the growth of gram positive. They are promoting the growth of gram negative, but suppressing the growth of gram positive. That means, which one? McConkey. Because gram positive is inhibited by the bile salts. It has bile salts. McConkey, it has bile salts. So they will inhibit the gram positive, but they will promote the growth of gram negative, right? Differential, because it has gram negative, that ferments lactose turns yellow. So all over gram negative, even in gram negative, some have tendency to ferment the lactose. So they will turn yellow in there because of change in pH or acidic condition. This is again EMB, eosine methylene hue, green metallic sheen appearance, right? Then there is how media is prepared in the laboratory, mainly solid media. They will be measured accurately and they will be autoclaved, right? pH which will be adjusted. In some case, acid and base is added to maintain the pH, because pH is mandatory, right? And it is being autoclaved at this temperature for this temperature, right? But we have seen there are certain cases where temperature cannot be applied. In that case, filtration is used. What has happened? Like in heat sensitive materials, all the antibiotics, enzymes, enzymes, vaccines, all these are filtered at room temperature using bacteria proof filters by a process called tindalization. Okay, here what happens? First day, strain is being passed for 1 hour, okay, and then there will be 3 consecutive days strain will be passed, and they are incubated. Once strain is passed, then they are incubated at this temperature. So what will happen? Firstly, due to strain, most of the vegetative microbes, they will get killed. Vegetative microbes, they will get killed, and they will be incubated. The spores which are present over there, because temperature was not raised to that temperature, suppose they will grow next day. Again, steaming will be done. The spores which have grown, they have converted into vegetative cells, they will get killed. Again, they will be steamed, and third day they will be incubated. Again, they will grow. Again, they will be steamed. This is how the liquids are sterilized without the temperature rising above 100 degrees Celsius. This is applied for all the antibiotics, enzymes, right? That's it we have in different types of culture media. Thank you.